The simulation of Proteus. So let me share this. Okay, first of all, in order to run Proteus, we need these files. That's the executable file, the application that we run Proteus. P324i, that means that 324 is the 324th version of Proteus, so there are many of them. Now we are more than we're exceeding this number. Each version has several characteristics. For example, the I in the end means that this executable is modified, for example, to increase dumping into the calculations, etc. The next one is dump file. Dump stands for damage. So we define the damage compartments of the vessel. There is a setup information file. The R file that defines how this simulation is going to run. So we're going each one of files, we're going to explain them. The assembler source file, S file. So we define the damage cases that we want to run, for example, the damage length, etc. The SUSE file, that is the geometry of the hull. It's actually identical to damage file without the damage openings. And finally, we have the batch file because Proteus is run from a compiler window. So instead of this, we can use a batch file to run the model. So I have to state that Proteus has the ability to combine things. That's the main advantage of Proteus. And as I stated before, for example, the Rankine code was known for years before the development of this code. What else I have to state here? Let's move to R file. All of these R, DAM, SUSE, and S files are open with Notepad. So we open this. R file contains all the interfaces that we need to run Proteus. These three HSM VAG, I don't really know what that is mean, but 3.11 is something like Proteus version. We have to state that all the lines starting with dash and these that are empty, they are not taken into calculation. We have to find the geometry as a SUSE or a G file. G funnel is the geometry, so Proteus can use both of these files. After that, we write the name of the file that we're going to use, the SUSE file. So if we're going to the SUSE file, we see that one. Of course, does not make sense. There are hull ID sections. There are some sections that are symmetrical, but as you can see, it doesn't make sense. Maybe you can see that the 170 is the length of the vessel, 27.10 is the breadth, the trim draft is 6.25 meters. But an accurate way to open SUSE file to see what's going on there is Polycad. So Polycad is another executable file. It's free, so you can obtain it for free. And you open a new project. Well, again. Maybe there is. You can try it from this computer, maybe because maybe the license is not activated, but it's free. So let's try to open it from here. Okay. So quickly move from. Here. Okay. We can open this file as import HAL definition source file. You can see, sorry. Thank you. Today's tutorial then. And source file. So now we can see this the vessel. So we have a clearly graphical representation of what's going on there. You can see these compartments. Okay. You can adjust from the toolbar. Let's do it. Used to like I don't know when I pressed F11 now it doesn't want to work. We have this we have to select each compartment of the vessel. I don't know how we can I can't do that right now. Okay, you can see when I select everything now I select it all and then color is yellow. Entity list, yeah. 11. So, here are the compartments of the vessel. The main hull, and the main garage. So we have the five sections. It's important to say that when we have large surfaces in Proteus, it's better to split these surfaces into smaller parts. Because we want to have as more accurate results as possible to the water ingress. So, and we split this surface into smaller parts, but we connect these parts together. So we use this polycut for the source file. I quickly skip that one and. Not going to use this information. So let's move to the other laptop. Sorry about that. Except from source file, there is a dump file that is identical. So in this file, we can define the damaged compartments of our vessel. So let's open a damage file. It's also as a notepad. Here's the name of the damage file, PRR01. There are five groups that are defined in this file. Also the openings. As you can see here, there are two openings active. All the rest are inactive due to this dash in front of the line. And each compartment is defined in X, Y, Z coordinates. So we have these for all the compartments, car 4, afterward, port, mid section, mid section, starboard, etc. It's the same with the graphical representation, is the same with the SUS file. We're open the R file now. So we have to define the SUS file first. This zero is we use it in point, we want to generate a G version of the SUS file, but usually this tends to be zero. After that, we have to calculate this to define if the damage, this switch here, one means that the damage is on, otherwise if it's zero, it's off. The time to open in seconds, so when we run the simulation, from what time after we run the simulation, this time is going to be the damage openings. So let's say that we wanted 30 seconds after the simulation, but this is also 30 seconds is something according to the regulations in order to have a stability to achieve something, a stability between the vessel and the environment before running the damage, before opening the damage, let's say. After that, we define the damage of our vessel. So it's a dump file that we mentioned before. One, that one here means if we want a damage rating report, this is something useful when we want to have reports for our calculations. One here means that swell and here that wave kinematics are taken into consideration. That one zero is when ship kinematics were taken into consideration. And the last one is the DGD. It's DGD is something, a library that create rooms so we have a free surface effect calculation. If this is zero, the DGD, we don't have free surface effect. Free surface effect is important when you have a large spaces. For example, if we run the simulation for a ro-ro ship, like Estonia. If we run the simulation for a cruise ship, where we have a lot of small spaces, this isn't so important. But we have to say that the time to run the simulation is significantly higher when this is one. But due to the, because we're running this from a laptop, we keep this to zero. And it's not in the purposes of this to have it one. After that, we want, if we want to define to have cargo shifting on board, this is one, otherwise it's zero. And but in order to run the calculations with cargo shifting, we have to define the cargo with, as a different file. And now that's the most vital part of the R file in order to run the calculation. The calculation specification. So in order to have a frequency domain, rouse, etc. Calculation, this switch should be zero. In order to start the time calculation, so the damage simulation that we want to run, this switch is one. But before doing that, we have to define our vessel's characteristics in a static equilibrium. So that's the switch number two. We have to define the GZ curve for our of our vessel, that's the three. And of course, to create a database that with these three files, we have to run the the simulations. Finally, the 5.1 are for the IV files, but this is not so important now on. As I said before, these are the modes of motions that need to be accounted for the initial conditions. We have search, sway, heave, roll, pitch, and yaw. As it says that sometimes we need just the 4 degrees of freedom in Proteus. We can run it with both of the degrees. But when we're talking about the dominant case, search, yaw, motions are not taken quite often in consideration. So we neglect these degrees of freedom from now. After that, we have to define ship mass parameters. The moment of inertia regarding X, Y, and Z axis, and center of gravity. In Proteus, there is a possibility to run the simulation using either regular or irregular waves. So for regular waves, this switch is 1. And for irregular waves, for example, we use Jonshoff model, we use 3. So this switch here is 3 for regular wave environment. 5 here represent the significant wave height. So it's up, usually it's up to 5 meters, because when we have a situation on board, it's not quite often to have more than 5 meters wavelength. So in order to have an accurate simulation, let's say we run the simulation from 1 to 5 meters with step of 0.5 meter. So we have about 10 simulations. This 0.04 is a slope of the wave, so it's Hs over lambda. 3.3 is the gamma, and we used 256 harmonics to run the simulation. These two values are taken from the ITCC, so they're quite standard to run the simulation. So we obtained this value from ITTC, International Towing Time Conference. Wind is also taken into consideration. Here we neglect wind, but we can define also the velocity of the wind as a meters per second. Here is 12 meters per second, but as I said, we neglect the wind for the calculations. One means that the wave is randomized. That this is very important, because if we want to run the simulation, the same simulation, more than one time, we need this wave to be randomized, but the characteristics of the wave remain the same. For example, the Jonshoff with 5 meters HS and the same slope and gamma, but the period when the simulation starts is different. So it's not so often to achieve, actually it's quite impossible to achieve exactly the same wave phase when the damage starts to take place. FK actual stands for the Fruit Krylov forces. So it's time that ship changes attitude, that's the actual. And we have to recalculate these forces. This usually is taken into consideration in very big waves, or when we have a small ship in high seas. You know, also it's used when we don't want to run damage simulation, but just to simulate the behavior of the vessel in high sea. So there's no need to have damage simulation. For now, we keep this zero. Zero also is the force constant update. Here we define the heading of the vessel against the waves. So it's 90 degrees. We can parameterize this to the heading that we want. So run it from 0 to 360 degrees. After that, we define the speed of our vessel. But in order to do the survivability test with the speed, We need a special file that has all the data from the rudder of the vessel. Here the T max is 1800 seconds, i.e. 30 minutes. That's the minimum, the time that is required by the regulations to run the simulations. And here one means that we want to print our results. So we have to see what we've done. here we need the results regarding static stability. So we need to take trim into consideration to have a free trim, let's say, not a fixed one. The same starts with heel. One is if we have a free heel for the intact static stability. And the P stands for port, EVS stands from the starboard. Here is the GZ range step. So let's say that we want it from minus 10 degrees to 30 degrees with step of 1 degree. So this is very useful when we're going to run the simulation for the GZ curve over there. Here's the database that we want to create. So we need these files in order to create the database for the sink of the vessel. So for in which draft we want to create the database, we can create the database more than one draft, of course. The heel, the trim, the speed. For example, we leave this zero because we want a static state. So we leave this in zero. The speed, let's say that we want to run it, the database for 0 knots and 15 knots, and the frequency of 50 hertz with step of 2.5, and heading for 90 degrees. So if we create the database for 90 degrees, so here we can go and write 90 degrees to heading in order to start the calculation. If we write, for example, here 90, 130, 150, etc. After that, we obtain the database, we can run the simulations. And finally, here we define the build plate of our vessel, so the thickness and from where it starts and where it ends. So this is 60 meters long. Build skill. So we define this before running the simulations, of course. Regarding that part, we don't touch it. It's something dumping frequencies here. It's the IKEDA method. So when we define all of this, we are ready to run the simulation. But first of all, here we start with a static equilibrium. So we put here the switch 2, we close it, save changes, and we simply run the test. Okay, so you can see that the two folders created, one with LIB, that stands for library. That is the outforce, but we have here the static equilibrium calculations. There are two dehydrostatic calculations. Here is the ship name and the model that we used. We have the principal characteristics of the vessel, the LPP, breadth, draft, mass, and the center of gravity. The ship defined as damage, so if we want to neglect the damage, we're going back to the R file and set this value to zero. So if we will do it later on. And here we have the how can I say this, the let me see. Okay. Do you have any questions? Not now. Questions? Okay. Distant learners, any questions? Except from the uploading of the slides, let's say. Okay. So we can see that we obtain a syncas of minus 0.584. So the draft increased by 0.6 meters. We have a trim of 0.225. The trim is positive by bow, so it's like that. A heel of minus 2.9 degrees, so P minus stands from the, I think, the starboard side. So we're going back to the R file and set the damage to zero, as we said before. Close it. First of all, we have to delete this, because an error will appear. And continue. So now we obtain the intact ship conditions. The syncas of actually identical to the design draft. No trim and no heel. That's the inventor file. It's not so often used. And it describes some coordinates with section. So we're going back to our file, let's say. And sorry, to this file, to the static file, we see the mass. We have to ensure that it's the same with the R file here. So the mass should be. You observe that if the these numbers are different, you can see this is kilos, this is tons. So the center of gravity should be the same. So minus 2.55, yes, it is 0 and 13.170. The moment of inertia should be the same. Let's check. It's something trial and error, but now we obtain the accurate values from the ship's mass parameters. After that, we define the we run the simulations for the obtain the GZ curve. So I simply change the switch to 3, close it, and run the batch file. We successfully created the GZ file. It's in the library. Here's our GZ values, but of course we cannot see very clearly the GZ values here, so we export this to an Excel file. Okay, and we simply create a graph of the GZ curve. So okay. Up to now, it seems quite smooth graph, but we don't have enough data after 30 degrees, let's say. So what we have to do we'll go back to the R file. So as you can see from R file, we can control everything. And here, in the GZ range step, it's from minus 10, and we set it from 180 degrees, the step again of 1 degree. We close it, delete again the GZ curve here, because we an error will occur, but something. Common and start. Now you see that we're calculating this for up to 180 degrees. Okay. Going back to our file. Okay. Let's go here. And repeat the same procedure. Here's our graph. It seems quite smooth and normal graph for this type of vessel. Of course, we don't need the data from let's say 60 degrees, so we can format the axis, let's say from minus 10 to 60 degrees. Okay, and of course here from minus 1 to 1. You can see that we have a very smooth GZ curve. There are no irregularities or steps or something. It's very smooth curve. If we have these irregularities, that means that something is wrong with our geometry. So we have to redefine the geometry. We have to check what's going wrong there and define the GZ curve. So we can see that the point of no return is over there. It's smooth graph, it's quite smooth graph. We close this and minimize this. So the next step is to generate a database. So we simply switch to database creation. And here we want, for this draft, this hill, this stream, these two speeds for 0 and 50 knots, these frequencies, this and this heading. We can add as many as we want, but this will increase the simulation time. So we simply save it and run the batch file. You can see that it runs from these frequencies, this speed, to 90 degrees heading with data. This RSM is for ranking to source method, so the hydrodynamic regularity segments, subsections, and try to simulate the presence of the body in the potential flow field. It's actually the potential the ceiling. Imagine like that. Now it's quite long, you know, it's as you can see with two parameters for speed. That also depends of the of what type of computer are you using to run the simulation, of course. Any questions so far? No. So we're going to the second speed, 50 knots, as you can see here. If we move to the library file now, you can see this F file. That was just generated. This matrix has 18 coefficients, so it's but actually 6 by 6 matrix. The first 6 coefficients are regarding the added inertia. The other 6 are regarding damping, and the last 6 regard the restoring forces. So the number of frequencies up to 2.5 for heading of 90 degrees. You can see here the 53 frequencies from 0.05, 0.1, 15, etc. So this matrix runs for these frequencies. The same applies, of course, with the 15 knots. This data was for 0 knots speed. These inventory files, as I said, were not interested in them. In them, were not they're not used quite often. So, don't know how long it is. Not so much. Just 6 calculations more. Okay, so now we have the database. We just created all the database that we need. We ensure first of all that the static is okay. We see that the GZ curve is okay. We created the database, and now we are ready to run the simulation. So the vessel is damaged. We're simply going to switch number 1, that is time simulation, and as we stated, it's from it wanna be for run for 30 minutes, and it will start the damage simulation after 30 seconds. So we simply close this, and now the simulation started. We can observe some results here. For example, the vessel heel, the draft, here's the time, of course. So this simulation is quite long. One. But we want to check, if we want to check what our results are about before closing the simulation or before end the simulation, we just simply press P, we print the results temporarily, and the simulation starts to run. So it's quite useful tip, I think. As you can see, there are a lot of files added. A file that calculates that has a result via bandage forces, damping forces, wind forces, excitation, external, gyroscopic. This was the file that we've seen before. The kernel, that's the most important, the MOT. MOT stands for motions file. So if we open this, we have everything here. We have when we run the simulation, of what version of Proteus. We know the geometry file, the ship's name, again, all the vessel's principal characteristics, moments of inertia, center of gravities, the speed, the heading, we see if the ship is damaged. So we have everything here, wave, so everything is here. So now, that's the 6 degrees of freedom. That's the wave, characteristics, and the time. So if we export this table to an Excel file. A new one. Okay. So we want again to create a graph regarding the ship's rolling. So we simply hide this. We create the data. That we want. So that's a graphical representation of that's a time and the degrees of a vessel. But if we want to be more accurate, we have to wait until the simulation stops. But you see that we have the results of still in the 561 second 61st second. But let's print again the results. And we use a program called Monolux to see what we've done, how the vessel is going to be response to this damage. I simply switch, let me switch my screens first before we move. That's a good thing. Okay. Never mind. We use Monolux. I don't have here. Sorry about that. And this is a graphical representation of what we've seen before. The, for example, the Estonia or the other representations that were in the mathematical model. So that's a basic idea and a basic example of what how Proteus is running. Do you have any questions before we finish for today? No, thank you. Any questions? Something? So, thank you very much.